snake came to my water trough on a hot, hot day, and I, in pajamas for the heat, to drink there. In the deep, strange, scented shade of the great dark carob tree, I came down the steps with my pitcher and must wait, must stand and wait. For there he was at the trough before me. He reached down from a fissure in the earth wall in the gloom and trailed his yellow-brown slackness soft-bellied down over the edge of the stone trough and rested his throat upon the stone bottom and where the water had dripped from the tap in a small clearness. He sipped with his straight mouth, softly drank through his straight gums into his slack long body, silently. Someone was before me at my water trough, and I, like a second comer, waiting. He lifted his head from his drinking as cattle do, and looked at me vaguely, as drinking cattle do, and flickered his two-forked tongue from his lips, and mused a moment, and stooped and drank a little more. Being earth-brown, earth-golden, from the burning bowels of the earth, on the day of Sicilian July, with Etna smoking, Sicily, the black snakes are innocent, the gold have animus. And voices in me said, if you were a man, you would take a stick and break him now and finish him off. But must I confess how I liked him? How glad I was he had come like a guest. In quiet to drink at my water trough and to depart peaceful, pacified and thankless into the burning bowels of this earth. Was it cowardice that I dared not kill him? Was it perversity that I longed to talk to him? Was it humility to feel so honored? Still more, that he should seek my hospitality from out of the and I have something to expiate, a pettiness. Thank you.